Hey, good morning. Welcome to another program we prepare for you on a Sunday morning. Let's bow our head and pray. The Heavenly Father, thank you for being our God, our wonderful God, our awesome God. And we are thankful that we have another day to live and to stay healthy, and also a chance for us to experience your wonderful grace and your awesome creations. And this morning when we come before you, we would just like to bring you honor and praise and all the respect. And we ask that you bless our time together. Help us to learn more about you and ourselves and our relationship with you through the song and through the scriptures reading and the Bible passage that we're going to read. We ask that you touch our heart. You help us to learn, help us to focus, and mold us into a person that is pleasing to you. Lord, once again, we ask that you bless our time together. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good morning. Happy Sunday. We have another opportunity to worship the Lord together and open the Bible and find out what our God has to teach us today. And as you know, we've been going through the attributes of God, the whole series. We'll continue on that today. But before we learn anything new, I would just like to do a quick review of what we have learned so far. We have learned so much in the last many weeks, and as you know, just like last week, I'm going to skip one particular attribute on our list and see if you figure out what I skip. Okay, here we go. God is omnipresent. God is almighty. God is compassionate. God provided the perfect sacrifice. God is faithful, God is wise. He is love, God heals his people, God protects his people. He is omniscient, God is just, God is trustworthy, he is our hope. He is exalted, God saves, and God is holy. So which one did I skip? That's right, the attribute that we missed is God is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. So today is actually lesson 18, and we'll learn yet another attribute of God. Remember, we have already learned that God is omnipresent, and that means that he is everywhere at any time. And God is omniscient, meaning that he is all-knowing. So today we will complete that trio, the Omni Trio, with God is omnipotent. Before we go into the scriptures and our discussion, let's worship the Lord through music and let the melodies and the words help us express our gratitude and honor to our Lord, because he's so worthy of our praise. We have to recognize that he is our God. And in fact, the title of the song is Our God. None like you. Today's scripture's reading is from Psalm 33, verse 1 to 9. Sing joyfully to the Lord, you righteous. It is fitting for the upright to praise him. Praise the Lord with the harp. Make music to him on the 10th-stringed lyre. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully and shout for joy. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of his unfailing love. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, their starry hosts by the breath of his mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea into jars. He puts the deep into storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the people of the world revere him. For he spoke, and it came to be. He commanded, and it stood firm. Hey kids, how are we doing? Are you doing anything to stay healthy? I have to be honest with you that I must have gained some weight during this shelter in place order. And when staying home, there is always more access to snacks and drinks and ice cream and all the good stuff. And sometimes if I want a break, I would go out and grab a sugary boba drink. Not the healthiest thing in the world. I'm also less active when staying home. We do try to go hiking and at least, you know, go for a walk in the neighborhood, but that's just not enough. It's simply not enough to build up the strength that I need for my body. And I hope that you're really doing much better than me, as it is important to have good physical strength to battle what is before us nowadays. So speaking of strength, can you name five of the strongest animals on the earth. I will give you exactly 30 seconds to come up with your answers. So think about that, and then we're gonna ask you to name 5 animals on the earth that are the strongest. So here we go. So what do you think? There are several surprises on the list, and we can't really underestimate the strength of those little guys, right? Today we'll discuss the strength and power of God, and the topic is God is omnipotent. Omnipotent means that God is almighty or infinite in power. To help us understand that truth, that God is omnipotent, we are going to look at a story, probably familiar to most of you, of a very strong man in the Bible who loses his strength at the end. And to give you some hints, this strong man may look somewhat like, you know, some of you who haven't had a haircut for a long time. So please open your Bible and turn to Judges chapter 16, verse 2 through 30. And as you read, I'll leave the screen on with some music. And after that, I will play a very short and very interesting video clip to help you visualize the story. And then after that, we'll come back for more discussions. Thank you.
My name's Dan. This is my buddy Andrew. And we're here to tell you the story of a man named Samson.
Oh, I know that guy. He's like super strong and fought like a bazillion dudes, and he had like super long hair.
Okay, hold on. Don't spoil the story. We're gonna get to all that stuff. Let's start at the beginning when Samson was just a baby.
A super strong baby?
Nope, just regular baby. One day, an angel told Samson's mom and dad that God had a very special plan for his life. Samson would be a hero. You see, at the time, his parents and all the other Israelites were being bullied by the Philistines.
Oh no, not Philistine. I've heard of that guy. He's bad news.
No, it wasn't a guy named Phil. It was the Philistines. And they were some really bad dudes. God wanted Samson to take him out.
So he grabbed his bazooka.
No, he didn't have a bazooka. God gave him super strength to defeat the Philistines. Wait, what's going on there?
He defeated them, get it?
Oh boy. Now, if Samson wanted to keep his super strength, there were some rules that he had to follow.
Oh yeah, like sit up straight and tall, don't pick your neighbor's nose.
Nope, Andrew, those are our rules. Samson's rules were different. Rule number one, he was never allowed to cut his hair.
Never?
Nope.
Not even like a little off the top?
No way, Jose. If Samson's hair was ever cut, he would lose all of his strength.
Yikes.
Rule number two, he wasn't allowed to eat any unclean food.
Wait, unclean food? You mean like food that fell on the ground and got dirty? Hello, 5-second rule.
No, not exactly like that. You see, back then there were certain things that the Israelites couldn't eat. Like pigs.
Whoa, hold up, wait a minute. You're telling me that Samson couldn't eat bacon?
Well, yeah.
Then Samson died. The end.
What?
Yeah, man. Who would want to live in a world without bacon?
No, it was okay. Samson didn't mind because he had super strength, remember?
Oh, yeah, and he had that sweet ponytail.
Yeah, that too. As Samson grew up, he followed the rules and became incredibly strong.
Like, how strong?
Check this out. One day, he was walking down the road, and a huge lion attacked him.
Man, it seems like there was a real lion problem back then. I mean, everyone's just always getting attacked.
Samson fought back and tore the lion to pieces with his bare hands.
What? He had bare hands? That would be awesome. You could, like, catch fish and climb trees and eat all the honey. Awesome.
No, Andrew, that's ridiculous.
Wait, question. Did Samson wear shoes?
Probably not all the time.
So he had bare feet, too?
No, regular hands and regular feet, okay? So another time, Samson was surrounded by a ton of enemy soldiers. They wanted to kill him. They all had weapons and armor, but Samson had nothing.
Oh boy, this doesn't look good. Bye-bye, Samson.
Well, not quite. He looked around and saw something on the ground. It was the perfect weapon. The jawbone of a donkey.
What?
He picked it up and started fighting. When the dust settled, Samson had killed 1,000 enemy soldiers.
Dude, this guy is awesome. What else did he do?
All right, get this. Samson was in an enemy city, and the Philistines tried to trap him inside. They shut the huge metal gates, and there was no way out. But Samson just grabbed the giant doors, and he tore them off.
Sweet!
But Samson had a problem. He didn't pick very good friends. He spent lots of time with people who didn't love God. And he even started hanging out with some Philistines.
Oh no, what are you doing, Samson? Don't hang out with Phil!
Eventually, Samson became best friends with a Philistine woman named Delilah.
Wait, he's not even supposed to be hanging out with the Philistines, right?
No way, man. Delilah was not a good friend. She was trying to trick him.
A trick? Pick a card. Any card.
No, not a magic trick. Like, the bad kind of trick.
The bad kind. What'd she do?
Delilah was secretly working for the Philistine army. She wanted to find out what made Samson so strong so that they could capture him.
That girl is poison.
She begged Samson to tell her the secret to his strength. She asked over and over and over until finally Samson gave in.
No!
He told her that if his hair was cut, he would lose his strength. That night, while Samson was sleeping, the Philistine army snuck into his tent and cut his hair. He woke up and he tried to fight, but he was weak.
Oh no, get out of there, Mr. Clean!
They tied him up, but he couldn't break loose. His super strength was gone.
Aw, man, no more bare hands, no more bare feet, no more super baby.
The Philistines took him away and made him a slave for the rest of his life. God had an awesome plan for Samson, but he messed it up when he started hanging out with the wrong kind of people.
So don't hang out with anyone named Phil.
No. People named Phil are fine. Just make sure and remember Proverbs 12:26. Pick your friends carefully.
Welcome back. And please keep your Bible open to Judges chapter 16, verse 2 to 30. And I will highlight a few key concepts or things on this very passage. So when Samson was a baby, his parents dedicated him to God and made a promise that his hair would never ever be cut as a sign of his dedication. And God gave Samson great strength and used him to do a lot of amazing things to protect God's people and fight for God as well. But like all people, Samson grew proud of his own strength and let the sin of pride enter his heart. And Samson loved a Philistine, and we know that Philistines, they were enemies of God's people, and that Philistine lady is called Delilah. And the Philistines wanted to use Delilah to defeat Samson. Delilah asked for the secrets of Samson's strength, and Samson lied and said if he was tied with 7 fresh bowstrings, he would lose his strength. So she tied him up and called the Philistines, and when they got there, Samson broke the bowstrings and defeated the Philistines. And Delilah got mad at Samson for lying to her and asked again how he could lose his strength and power. And this time, Samson said he had to be tied up with new ropes, ropes that have never been used before. So she tied him up one more time, called the Philistines, and boom, here they came again. And Samson broke the ropes and defeated the Philistines. So Delilah asked another time, one more time, that how to get rid of his strength. And this time he said that his hair had to be woven into a carpet loom. And Delilah did exactly that and called the Philistines again. And when they arrived, he broke free and one more time defeated the Philistines. So she asked another time. And even though Samson should not have done so, but because of his love to this lady, because also he thought that he was unbeatable, he told her the truth. He told her that his hair should never ever been cut, and if she cut his hair, he would lose his strength. That's the truth, as we know. Then she lured him to sleep, cut off all his hair, and called the Philistines again to come and attack Samson. And when they arrived, he tried to fight them up, but this time he had lost all of his strength. The Philistines captured Samson, blinded him, and made him into a slave, very sadly. After some time, Samson thought that about what he had done, and he repented of his pride and prayed to God to give him back his strength one more time. So God answered his prayer, and at just the right moment, Samson pushed against the pillars in the hall where the Philistines were being at, and the building crumbled down on top of him, and all of the Philistine rulers were there, and they are all dead. So that's a quick wrap up of the story, and today's topic is God is omnipotent. Omnipotent really means that almighty or infinite in power. It means almighty and infinite in power. In this story, Samson lost his power. But we know that God can never lose his power. And God's power is infinite. There's no beginning and there's no end. And in Joshua chapter 4, verse 24, it goes like this. He's talking about God. He did this so that all the peoples of the earth might know that the hand of the Lord is powerful, and so that you might always fear the Lord your God. That's Joshua chapter 4, verse 24. That Bible verse clearly tells us that God is powerful, and we have to respect that. And not just respect and fear, but to also realize that truth and put our trust on a God who is infinite in power, such a powerful God that who will always be there for us. What a promise, and what a promise that we can hold on to when we need help, we need strength. So before we go, I would like to give you a summary of what we have learned today. In our story this morning, we saw a very strong man, and we know how he got his strength from God. And because God is all-powerful, infinite in power, we know that he is omnipotent. He can give power to people when he wants to, and he can take the power back and take it away whenever he wants to. God has unlimited power. And how did Samson lose his power? True, it happened because his hair was cut off, but ultimately it was because he forgot that it was God himself who gave him the power, and God would take it away. And like all sin in anyone's life, Samson began to believe that he was the one in control and forgot about God and where his power come from. And the story of Samson and the way his life was destroyed by sin reminds us that the truth that sin destroys all of our lives, and that we are all sinners who have forgotten that God is God and we are not. That's something very important. Oftentimes we try to play the role of God and thinking that we are unbeatable, but we are really not. And only God is the one with infinite and power, and he's almighty. And the answer to the sin problem in our lives is the same as the answer that Samson saw. The only way we can be forgiven of our sin and life is to repent or turn away from our sins and believe that Jesus died for you and me and paid the price for our sin. That is the only way to repent and admit that we are sinful, we have sinned, and we believe that Jesus Christ died for all of us on the cross and paid the price for our sin as well. And thank God for the ways that he has shown his power to us in our life through creation and his salvation, and pray that all of us will come to the understanding that he is almighty, infinite in power, and he is much more than we sometimes think he is. So I will give you three challenges this week and give you some questions to think about throughout the week. And hopefully that helps shape how you approach things in life. First, do you trust and rely on your own physical and mental strength when problem comes your way? Okay. And after today's lesson, do you see that there's another option? So I would like you to think about that. Second question, to build your physical strength, we know we need to have a balanced diet, we sleep well, and we exercise as often as we should. But how do we get strengthened spiritually? And what would you do to grow and get stronger as a follower of Christ? Give you some hints. Remember the true source of your strength and where it is coming from, or who is giving you that. So think about that question as well. Number three, what is the strongest material in the world today? Now, I know some of you may be just yelling at the screen saying that it's diamond. It is not. So do some research on that. We'll share the answer with you next week. So before we go, just would like to remind everyone to stay healthy, stay in touch, and also, most importantly, stay with God. And I'll see you here next week, next Sunday at 9:30 a.m. You take care and goodbye.